Why? Well, mounting concern over a disease called chronic traumatic encephalopathy, more commonly known as CTE. In the world of medicine, CTE is a relative newcomer. In football, we just learned about it 10 to 15 years ago. Here's what we can say. It's a progressive degenerative brain disease. It is like Alzheimer's. It can start with memory loss, mood swings, and difficulty in concentration, developing into progressive dementia, even possible thoughts of suicide. But unlike Alzheimer's, CTE can also result in significant aggression and lack of impulse control. The big difference, symptoms tend to begin much earlier in life, closer to your 40s instead of your 60s. In both diseases, there's no known cure. Researchers believe there's only one way to get CTE, and that is repeated hits to the head. What happens is that you get a buildup of an abnormal protein called tau in the brain. Scientists do know both the location of the tau and how much tau in the brain determines the symptoms you might exhibit. But scientists don't yet have a magic number of hits that results in CTE. It also isn't known who exactly would develop CTE. There are some players who take many hits and never develop symptoms. Factors like genetics and age of exposure to the trauma could play a role. How do you know if you have CTE? Just because you have symptoms doesn't mean you have the disease. In fact, as things stand now, you can only be diagnosed for sure after death. Scientists are researching how to diagnose in living people. A prominent group of researchers have found over 90% of former NFL players have developed CTE. But remember something important here. The number could be so high because of something known as selection bias. That means the brains that were studied were from people who worried that they had CTE. Also, it's not just football players that need to be concerned. Boxers, soccer players, people in the military, anyone who's exposed to constant head trauma can develop it too.
Ladies and gentlemen, if these men come down your chimney this Yuletide season, you better start a fire real quick.
For now, it's been 3 years since I came to the throne of Abudadine himself. My family has seen a lot. My family has traveled the astral plane from Bangkok to Singapore. The haze has arrived from the sea, reenacted from the first time he came to me and my hour of need. And that time my hour of need was again the same reason, Black Jack Mulligan and his family. You see, the golden-haired boy, Barry Windham, thinks he can get anything he wants. Well, you're going to get more than you reckon for, because the mask of darkness is now on me. And Black Jack Mulligan, I laid Kendall down twice. The breath of life is still in him. Don't push it any further. Because when the haze came back, this time, when he went to the Hall of Memories, and passion was erased from him, Meha Singh took the passion of the haze and took it to the sweatbox. And in the sweatbox, he started beating on it. And there was the joys of torment and sounds of silence. And Meha Singh showed me the difference between pleasure and pain. And what it is nothing but a thin line. The thin line that lies in my heart, Black Jack Mulligan. I'm a con. I don't believe in my conviction. I don't believe what I say. Black Jack Mulligan, what has happened now? And what will continue to happen is on your head.
Okay. Oh, do you ever watch a stupid movie late at night? Hope it doesn't get better. Don't get better, but keep watching it anyway. Because the other night, I was watching this movie. Called Fright Night, Freak Night, or some kind of night. But it's about vampires. I don't know if you know vampires are cool people, or they not. But I'm going to tell you something that I found out. A werewolf can kill a vampire. Do you know that? I never knew that, so I didn't want to be a vampire anymore. I wanted to be a werewolf. But then anyway, as I'm watching this movie, and then you tell how stupid it is, because it went in the morning. So I'm watching my TV, or these kids watching their TV, or a vampire kill on their TV. So you know it's kind of stupid, but I'm still watching though. As I'm watching this show, what was funny, these kids had a vampire in their attic at their house. So they're watching their TV. Now I'm watching my TV and they're watching their TV, but they see the vampire killer on their TV. So they win the contest to bring this actor. Now y'all got to stay with me. Bring this actor, he's a vampire killer, from that TV to get rid of this real life vampire in their attic. So if this actor comes to their home, he got all the right stuff. He got all the right stuff, because you got to have a stake, you got to have they killed him in the heart. And got necklace of garlic for that work. I don't know what it does, but it works. Gotta have a cause, cause it burns, I know that works. And then all of a sudden, this is what I'm so funny about. As they're walking through the house, this guy got the holy water, he's blessing the house. This actor, now he's all fake. He blessed the house with his holy water. They walked upstairs and this vampire looking real good in this black suit. Whoa, that sounds like Samuel Warnock, doesn't it? Looking all good in this black suit. Floating from the ceiling. He floated from the ceiling looking good and cool. And I'm thinking, whoa, they better get out of that house. If somebody float from your ceiling, get out of that house. That's not your house. But as he floated from the ceiling, the kid jumped behind that hero. As they jumped behind that hero, the guy jumped in front of him with this holy water, threw it on the vampire's forehead. He covered his eyes. And he took his hand away. He started laughing. And he said, that don't work. He took the cross, he put it on the vampire's forehead. And the vampire didn't even do anything. He said, that don't work. And that's the way it is in our life. It doesn't work unless you got faith. It is time for us to have faith. We got to have faith in our fellow brother. We got to have faith in this country. We got to have faith in this in the elected officials. And right now, that's the reason I'm here. Because God...
Lately, it's been difficult to talk about football without mentioning concussions. Why? Well, mounting concern over a disease called chronic traumatic encephalopathy, more commonly known as CTE.